Namaskar, dear friends and my dear students. Today I am going to discuss regular and irregular verbs. Well, many students ask me this question. Sir, how many verbs do we have to learn by heart? There are so many verbs in English and there are so many irregularities in the spellings. So, how to learn so many verbs? How to remember so many verb forms? So, my dear friends, students, today I am going to answer that question with some clarity and with some tips. My previous video lesson was about helping and main verbs. The link of that has been given in the description. You can visit that link and watch that video as well. Okay, let's start today's topic, that is regular and irregular verbs. Now, some students think that the verbs that we use regularly, the verbs which are very frequently used and common in English, they are the regular verbs. And the verbs which are not very commonly used, which do not occur in our conversation very regularly, they are the irregular verbs. But it is not so. The regularity of uses here is not the question. The question is the spellings of the different forms of the verbs. I hope you know that every verb has got three forms. Some grammar books will tell you that there are five forms as well, if you count the ing form and the s or es form. So first form is the root form of the verb, that is v1. v2, the verb 2, is the simple past form. v3, the past participle form. v4, the ing form. And v5, it is the root form plus s or es. Now, V1 and V5, these two forms are used in present tense. V2 is used in simple past. About that I have told in one of the video lessons regarding simple past. The link of that is given in the description. V3 is used in perfect tenses and passive voice. V4, that is used in progressive tenses. It has other uses as well. And V5, as I told you, it is used in simple present tense along with V1. Now, let us take one example, help. If you have to make the help verb past and past participle, we have to add simply ed. That means help, helped, helped. And we have helping and helps as well as V4 and V5 respectively. If we have to make the verb advice, simple past and past participle, we have to simply add D. So we make it advised, advised. V4 and V5 being advising and advises. So to make the verbs simple past and participle by adding D or ED, it is quite easy. So it is not necessary to learn by heart these verb forms like advise and help and suggest. We can give you some other examples as well, like play. We make it simple past and past participle by adding ed. But there are some other verbs, around 200 verbs in the list. You can see on the screen by my side, like be verb, like do, have, and a number of other verbs. These verbs do not follow this pattern. We cannot make them simple past and past participle by adding D or ED. In case of do verb, simple past is did and past participle is done. So this did and done, they seem to be totally different words. Similarly, in case of have, the simple past and past participle, it is had, H-A-D. Again, had is also a different word altogether, so we do not get this form by adding D or ED. This also doesn't follow that pattern. We can take the verb be, the most irregular verb, but it is very, very important. We have to learn these verb forms by heart. In case of be verb, be is the root form. Along with root form, we have in simple present tense other two variations, am and are. In simple past, we have was and were, past participle been, present participle being, being, and V5 B plus S, it is is. So, as I told you, there are around 200 irregular verbs, the forms of which we must learn by heart. A list will appear in the screen, you can see. But to start with, I would always suggest my students and my friends, the learners of English language, to learn these three verbs and their forms first. The first one is be, the second one is have, and the third one is do. Because these are the three verbs which are most frequently used, and there are some other verb forms also we have to learn, but these three are the most important. Be verb is used in making different tenses, various voices. We use have verb very frequently, and do is also a very important verb. My friends, please learn by heart these verb forms because it will help you in future, and while talking and writing there won't be any mistakes. So in my next video lesson, I am going to discuss a few more points regarding different categories of verbs, and I also will give you some more tips regarding the patterns of irregular verbs, because these irregular verbs also follow certain patterns while making the simple past and past participle. They follow, some verbs follow certain patterns, so I'll be discussing those patterns in one of my following video lessons. Please stay tuned. Bye-bye.